This third season will be quite interesting for us because it's like if somehow the challenge really starting. We had the first two seasons where we build up the team, and now we're facing the 2017 with two new riders and with the team with more experience. Also, the bike has improved through the last season. And also, okay, we see as a positive sign we lost the concessions, and we will be at the same in the same condition as our main competitor. So now we feel like we have to start the challenge. We have to start to challenge the biggest competitors, and yeah, we're looking at this season with a lot of interest. And normally we should improve. It's very difficult. Last season somehow was quite impressive to win a race only in our second year to get the podium. But especially, I will say we were very pleased to see the bike constantly close to the podium, on the podium in the second half of the season, often with both riders fighting for the podium. So this was a big achievement. And now the most difficult part is to continue this trend, is to continue in this way. And we feel that with Andrea, he comes to Suzuki with a lot of experience, is one of the top riders. We feel we can start to think since the first race at this type of challenge. So to be close to the podium, to be in the middle of the battle, it's very, very difficult, very, very hard battle, but we can be there. And with Alex, we're starting a road of growing him up in MotoGP. And we really think he has a lot of talent, and we will take the right time to build up his experience and to allow him to understand the MotoGP, the bike, the team. And as soon as possible, we hope to have both of them fighting in the middle of the package. We're looking at this season, we're looking forward to this 2017 season. Andrea is coming to us with a 4-year experience in MotoGP. So we found in the first testing very, very precise on his comments. He knows what he needs. He knows what we need to improve in a bike. And he explained very well, so we're looking forward to use his experience, and of course, together with his talent, to try to reach the best possible results. And Alex is bringing new energy, new excitement, new motivation, coming from the Moto2, young rider, young talent. We're looking at trying to transfer to him our 2 years' experience, and to teach him as much as possible, and to see him growing up, which is always very exciting as a team, to see a talent growing up and improving step by step during the season. So we started the season with these two situations, one expert rider and one young rider. But our target and our aim is to bring both of them as high as possible in the position through the season. During the last year, we improved a lot our performance on the track. We improved the engine performance, and our rider were, let's say, fast enough. And now we know that probably one area where we need to improve and to work more is the electronic. We think our package is quite well balanced in terms of chassis and engine. The engine will be further improved for the 2017. But as I say, we think that the electronic is the area where we have, let's say, more room of improvement. And this is something we have to work since the first test with our riders and improve that area. And then for sure, you know, all our competitors will improve a lot. They're working very hard on all the areas. So every year the competition is more difficult and the challenge is harder. But we are confident that if we will be able to get a good results on also on the electronic, we will have a better package. But we are a relatively a new team. We going into our third season, and for sure we have probably. Still, we are still in the excitement of this relatively new adventure. I can see all the people, all the guys in the team, highly motivated, with a lot of passion, willing to improve all our operation. And I think probably one of the good points which make me proud for the team is I see that everybody wants to improve, to make things better, to see the area where we can be better than the last race, or we can be better than the last season. And this, it's very important, and I hope it will last for long, because it's the way to improve our team operation, our team performance, while the rider will put their big effort on the track. Andrea comes to Suzuki having shown already that he's one of the top riders in the MotoGP. He won a race, and very often he was fighting for the victory. And so now we took a big challenge with him, because it's up to us now to provide to Andrea a good package that will allow him to continue to stay on the top group. On the top rider. So we expect a lot, of course, from him, and we expect him getting into the package and fighting for the podium and fighting for the victory. So we strongly wanted him in a team to use his talent, his ability, and his experience in a MotoGP. So we think we can make a step forward on our performances. As I say, his experience is very important to us, because after 4 years with another brand, he can probably identify our weak point, our strong point. He can address our engineers on the area of improvements. And we have found this already on the first testing, when we tested in Valencia and Jerez. He pointed out the major areas where we need to improve. Overall, he was quite happy about the bike, the package, the chassis, the engine performance. As we say, we have to improve the electronic area. But overall, I feel he was quite confident and quite relaxed on the package we have. And but his experience is very important for our next step of development. Of course, the crash was a problem, because we lost many days of testing, and we lost a good opportunity for him to get the feeling of the MotoGP. After only one day, he had a crash, we had to stop the testing. We could see in this first day some positive things that he was doing already on the bike. So we are quite confident that he can use the MotoGP, can bring the MotoGP at the top and use the full potential. But it's like, I think in Sepang, at the end of January, we have to kind of restart from zero with him. He only had one day testing in the MotoGP. And we will restart anyway our job. And we will try to, as I say, to use our experience with a rookie rider. We did this before. And we will see. We will see how quick we can bring him in a better and better position. But we think that he has a great talent, and he has a good potential to perform well. And we will start this this route from zero, and we'll see. It will be very exciting to see him growing up. I think the level we achieve is never enough, because the development never stops, and the engineer they never stop thinking of what we can improve. So we are going in our third season, and for sure there are more expectations, first of all from ourselves and also from all the world. And now we are no longer a rookie, no longer a new team, and so I would not say we are yet mature, but for sure we are growing up. And so we have to face always more and more difficult challenge, and we have to answer to higher expectation time by time. But it's a never-ending job. It's a never-ending thinking how you can improve, where you can improve, how you can do better. And this will continue, but the difference compared to before is that we won a race, we have more expectation, and we are much more a part of the competitive group of the MotoGP, I think.